Deputy Adams, thank you.
Going over to Concordia. Taoiseach, the ongoing revelations from the Anglo tapes continue to anger and to outrage citizens. And when I raised this issue with you last week, much of the focus was on who from within Fianna Fáil met with the bankers. And I invited Chuck De Martin, who was then a senior minister in the Cabinet, to make a statement to the Dáil setting out which Fianna Fáil ministers met with the bankers. Now, there still has been no response from the Fianna Fáil leadership on this. I've also asked you, Taoiseach, about the Anglo tapes and whether any other such tapes from other banks exist. And you told me that you didn't know. So I asked you, would you go and find out? So, Taoiseach, do we know now, a week later, if there are similar tapes from the other banks affected? Are there tapes from Irish Nationwide, Allied Irish Bank, the EBS, Bank of Ireland, from Irish Life and Permanent? Now, we all know famously that Anglo got 30 billion of taxpayers' money and these other banks received nearly 35 billion between them. That's over 64 billion euros from the pockets of the citizens. So, Taoiseach, do we know if the phone calls between these banks and the central bank were recorded by the central bank? You said there were no files of any value in the Department of the Taoiseach, although Fianna Fáil contests that. But what about the Department of Finance? What about the central bank? Can these files shed more light on what happened? And I'm sure you've met the real and very understandable cynicism from many people about whether the government's actually going to address these matters. And I suppose that's inevitable given the close relationship between the Golden Circles and some politicians and developers and speculators. And it was very much reinforced by some of these bankers being rewarded with well-placed and highly paid jobs. So Taoiseach, I think as part of trying to regain public confidence, it's central to all of that to know if there are tips from the other banks and if there are files in the Department of Finance and the Central Bank.
Thank you.
Well, the answer to your question is yes, there are tapes available in the other banks, and the Minister for Finance will be writing to those banks tomorrow, clearly setting out the position that these tapes be preserved in the interests of being available for a banking inquiry, which government will consider what form that should take in terms of the legislation that's currently going through the House. The tapes that were referred to in respect of the Anglo-Irish Bank only came to notice being the subject of a warrant, and a warrant by the Gardaí, who confiscated those tapes and sent them to the DPP, arising from which a number of files have been prepared both from the Gardaí and from the Office of the Director of Corporate Enforcement. And as Deputy Adams is aware, a number of charges have been laid against individuals. Yes, there is information available in the Department of Finance. The Gardaí have taken copies of some of that information. There is not a series of tape decks in the Department of Finance similar to that contained in the banks. But all of this information, I'm assured by the Minister, will be available for public discourse in the context of the form of inquiry to be held when government makes its decision as to what best and most appropriate form of inquiry of banking that should be, Deputy.
Thank you. Deputy Adams, 1 minute, thank you.
Taoiseach, excuse me if I'm a wee bit sort of discommoded by the fact that all of a sudden the Minister's going to write to these banks tomorrow. Tomorrow, this is five years ago, and last week he didn't know that there were any tips at all, and now, very conveniently, the Minister's going to rush out of here and write a letter and send it off tomorrow. Is this the type of approach that the government is taking to these issues? And do we have some sense, Taoiseach, that people just believe that there's one law for the well-connected, for the rich, and a different law for citizens who are out there, and no law for some? So I don't think that it's I don't think that it's sufficient that the government's doing what it's doing at this late hour, and I don't think that anybody out there will be persuaded about your intentions in this matter. So I leave it at that. I think that the government's handling of these matters has been absolutely dismal, and it's part of the national disgrace that this whole debacle has brought upon ordinary citizens out there, your neighbours, your family members, your constituents.
Yeah, well, let me remind you, Deputy Adams, that government have set in place an entirely new system of regulation and monitoring in terms of the way banks operate in the country. As you're aware, the dysfunctionality of the number of banks we had was changed, recapitalisation, new conditions that apply, and now in terms of mortgages, new targets and objectives to be set. You're wrong when you say that the government is only acting now in respect of these tapes that exist in other banks. There is a legal requirement on the banks, Deputy Adams, to retain those tapes for a period of time, for a set period of time. The minister's letter is merely a reminder to live up to their responsibilities in the sense of preservation of those tapes, which will be available for public information purposes and for the banking inquiry to be set up here under the parliamentary system. So it's a case of banks having a legal responsibility to hold these tapes for a period. Minister is merely sending them a letter to remind them of that responsibility so that they will be available for the public inquiry when the government decides what form that should take.
Thank you.